What's the ideal humidity level for your house? And how can you maintain this humidity level throughout the year? We have the answer starting right now. Hi, my name's Brian with Fire and Ice. When you hear about humidity, you might imagine a hot, sweltering day in the middle of July, especially if you live here in Columbus, Ohio. However, there's a lot more to humidity than you think, and the humidity levels inside your home play a large part in your overall comfort. In this video, we'll go over why humidity levels matter, what level they should be at, and how to measure and manage levels inside your home. By the end of this video, you'll know if humidity levels inside your home are contributing to your discomfort and how you can fix it. And if you find today's content helpful, subscribe to our channel for weekly educational content. In the country's more humid climates, all you need to do is spend 10 minutes outside in the middle of July to know just how uncomfortable it can be. In fact, humidity has a proportional relationship to the temperature we feel. Every 5% of relative humidity in the air equals 1 degree in temperature. Generally speaking, in the summer, humidity levels are higher and lower in the winter. That's why 72 degrees in the summer can feel uncomfortably hot, but too cold in the winter. The reason is too much or too little humidity. Humidity doesn't just affect temperature we feel, it can also pose other problems as well. If humidity levels are too high, you can see a higher prevalence of dust mites, mold, and mildew, which can result in health issues, allergies, hot upper floors, and trouble sleeping. When humidity levels are too low, it can result in dry, cracking wood, a higher chance of getting sick due to nasal passages drying out, dry, cracked skin, scratchy throats, and cold spots in your home. Needless to say, controlling humidity levels in your home is one of the easiest ways to become more comfortable in your home. Okay, so we know why humidity levels are important in your home, but what should the humidity level be inside your home? Experts recommend that humidity levels in your home be between 40 and 60%. To meet in the middle of those numbers, we recommend homeowners keep their house as close to 50% as possible. Anything below or above that threshold is where those problems start to present themselves. Before we move on, if you're enjoying this video so far, please like this video and leave a comment once you're done. We love to hear what you have to say and answer any questions you may have. And did you know we have even more resources on our website? Click the link here to visit our Learning Center for more in-depth information. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more great content. So we've gone over why humidity levels matter and what the ranges can be, but how do we manage it? First, let's talk about lowering high humidity. Believe it or not, your air conditioner does a lot of dehumidification during the summer. You can also increase the frequency your blower motor runs, even without your air conditioner running. However, if you experience a lot of humidity, investing in a whole home dehumidifier may be worth considering. It works by removing excess moisture in the air. For example, the April Air E100 dehumidifier is capable of removing 100 gallons of water per day. Not only can it help keep humidity levels down, but your air conditioner also won't have to work as hard, which saves you money in the long run. Humidity levels in the winter are the polar opposite. It's not uncommon to have humidity levels in the teens during winter and the air to be dry. For comparison, that's drier than the average humidity of the Sahara Desert. If this is a problem for you, a whole home humidifier is recommended. There are a number of options to choose from, but they all work similarly by adding moisture to your home, usually via the ductwork. Remember, every 5% increase in relative humidity equals a degree on your thermostat. Think of the cost savings you can achieve during the winter by allowing you to not have to run your furnace as much and still maintain the same level of comfort. Not to mention the health benefits associated with optimal humidity levels. By now you may be asking, how do you know what humidity levels are in your house? The easiest way is through a thermostat. Most modern thermostats have displays for humidity levels and can actively help manage the level. Another way of determining humidity levels is with a humidistat that is used to monitor humidity levels in an area. Most are digital and can be picked up from your local hardware store. And if you do choose a humidifier or dehumidifier, most come equipped with sensors that monitor humidity levels. I hope by now you have a better understanding of humidity and how to control it. If you'd like more information on humidity controlling solutions or heating and cooling solutions, click on the link in the description below. If you found this video helpful, feel free to like this video and be sure to subscribe for more great HVAC related content. Thank you for watching, and we look forward to making your day better.